Paper was like gold in medieval times.
Oh, not tobacco. Sugar.
That everything we thought we knew about the world might turn out to be completely wrong.
On this episode of Kim's Rude Awakenings.
Come back here and help me clean up!
You're so bloody lazy.
Through endless renovations, the McKnights are building their dream home.
This is a construction site.
It's covered in dust.
But a lack of cleaning has turned it into a nightmare.
You don't care, do you?
Nope. Domestic diplomats Kim Woodburn and Mike Shalhoub are on a serious mission. Their goal? To identify and confront messy and disorganized families and bring some sanity back into their lives and homes. Meet the McKnights. Mum Fiona is an executive assistant. Bill the dad is currently overseeing the family's renos, and they have two children, Max and Madison. Kim and Mike are on their way to help this family clean up all the dust and clutter from their ongoing renovations. Their goal is to make this construction zone look more like a show home.
It's always like an ongoing, never-ending thing. It's been a pigsty for the last 4 months.
Because the house is under constant construction, every room is unorganized and being used to store useless junk.
Max, let's go. You're doing nothing.
Mom and Dad are having a hard time keeping up with cleaning up, and the kids are absolutely no help whatsoever.
Come on, lazy bones. Come on.
I guess my responsibility would be sleep or leave a mess and then leave.
I can get really frustrated quite easily with the kids.
What are you doing on the computer? We've got work to do. Come on.
Is anyone going to answer me?
No.
It's almost like I'm being ignored at times.
If they could just be more proactive and help keep the house tidy.
I just want to make everything look peachy perfect when it's already fine.
Max really couldn't care. You know, I think it's the kick the stuff under the bed routine.
Maddie, this room is a mess.
I kind of like my room the way it is, dirty, because when people clean it up, I find a hard time finding things. I had this big ketchup packet collection, and I was going to use that at school, put it under the toilet seat, so when people sit down, squirt on their knees. But that didn't work out, because my mom cleaned it up.
We can't live like this. I've had it.
Mom and Dad want their home back from under all the dust, and they know to get there, the kids will need a reno on their attitudes.
Are you going to help me clean up now, Maddie?
Maddie, hello, hey, where do you think you're going?
I'm not a maid. I don't want to be a maid.
I'm at the pretty much at my wit's end right now. I'm on that.
They decided to call Kim and Mike to give this family a much-needed rude awakening.
Good morning, McKnight family. Kim and Mike here. We hear you're living in a construction zone.
You're always renovating, but you never clean up the white dust. Oh, no.
It's time to act like a team and clean up this mess. This is your rude awakening.
Let's go, babe. Come on.
Hi, Mike. Hi, Kim. Thank you so much for coming.
Why is there so much
There's an awful lot of white dust everywhere, lovey.
This is a construction site.
I'm always picking up. I'm always cleaning up. I'm tired of it.
Do you help out at all?
Sort of.
Oh. Excuse me. What is sort of? Sort of means you don't, doesn't it?
Pretty much.
Well, you're going to. I'm not putting up with this nonsense from you. This is Madison, isn't it?
Madison.
Miss Lazybones. Max, are you lazy as well?
No, unless I get paid.
Well, you're not getting paid from me. I don't like your insolence either, Cheeky Chops. Let's have a tour of this house.
Kids up, Dad up. Lead the way, family, lead the way.
Up first, it's Madison's room.
Well, why don't you clean it, dear?
It's hard to clean.
No, it's not. Your mum's so busy with the construction and cleaning up, she's not got time for this, lovey. And anyway, at your age, you can help a bit with your bedroom.
Don't you want to have a clean room?
No, not really.
What about when you bring friends home from school? You bring them here?
No, I just go to my friend's room, because he has a gecko.
You'd choke a gecko in here, dear. He'd be dead in half an hour with all the dust. He'd be lying on his back with his feet up in the air, dear, gasping for air.
I want to see the brother's room. Out.
Next up, it's Max's room.
Why is it so untidy and disgusting?
That's the way I like it.
It's not staying like this.
And rumor has it, Max, you hide everything under your bed, under your dresser. Is that how you clean?
Yep.
You don't care, do you?
Nope.
He's a horrible child, isn't he?
I want to see the basement.
Downstairs is no better. The kids' mess has turned their playroom into a storage room disaster.
Now, this is your playroom, is it?
Yeah.
Yeah, we usually have sleepovers down here.
I wouldn't stay down here if my life depended on it. Why do you never tidy up?
I don't know.
You're lazy, dear.
Yeah, Maddie, you're lazy.
Oh, you're going to talk.
I think it's great that this family keeps renovating the house, but you're renovating to make the house look better, but it's covered in dust from the basement to the roof. You're all to blame for that.
You four dwell on this dump.
Okay, come on.
I'm kind of.
Him and Mike have seen enough. The dust that comes with these household renovations has never been cleaned up. Clutter is everywhere in this do-it-yourself disaster, and these kids never tidy up the rooms, and more importantly, they just don't care. But before the family can pick themselves up and dust themselves off, Kim and Mike need to cleanse their palate with a spot of tea.
Kim, I need to teach these kids some manners.
Oh, good luck with that.
What are you going to do?
Well, I am going to show this family how to keep this white dust down.
Oof.
They should never let it build up in the first place.
You know, speaking about renovations, how are your renovations going at your house?
I'll tell you something.
Yeah.
It's not fun, you know.
Oh, gosh.
Now, you know what was nice, though? Now, fair dues. There were six guys in our house. Five of them had great bodies.
Okay,
Mike.
Yeah, I'm not interested.
You getting jealous?
Of what?
I think you are, you know.
Thanks to constant renovations, the McKnight family is living under a non-stop cloud of dust. And the only way to free the family from the overwhelming mess and clutter is to get everyone working on the same crew.
You're so bloody lazy.
Come on, lazy bones.
Since the McKnights don't mind living inside a construction zone, Kim and Mike have made them feel right at home outside on their front lawn. But in order to get back in, they need to prove that they can actually work together as a team and clean up this mess. It's time for the wake-up call.
What's this?
Whoa!
It's not normal, nor is it healthy, to live in a construction site, as you do.
You want all this put in there, dear.
I paid the contractors to do this.
Never mind that, lazy bones.
Nobody's getting into this house unless you clean up this construction site dump and you work together as a family, as a team.
And if you want to go to the loo, port a toilet.
You're joking.
I am not joking. I've got a loo roll in my hand.
You guys want a coffee break at all? We've supplied the coffee man for you.
Get on with it. Come on. Come on. Madison, don't stand looking gorgeous, dear. That's my job.
Come on, Madison.
There doesn't seem to be much speed going on here, does there? What do you keep dropping it down for? Max, what are you doing, dear? Get stuck in.
Come on.
It's all about working together.
Come along.
Help your sister, Max.
Where's this?
Oh, hey, Max. Help your sister. Max, help your sister.
But right now, Max seems to have another duty on his mind.
Good luck, Max.
Let's knock this thing over.
Come on, I can see the end of all this terribleness.
Help your dad there, Max.
Looks like Dad needs a hand.
No, take your time.
And the entire family has finally come together to finish a job, and Kim and Mike are pleasantly surprised.
We really worked as a team to clean up. The kids really pitched in, and I'm really hoping that they'll follow through with that kind of attitude of we all have to take part in cleaning up the house.
Well done, family. You see, look at the difference. Well done.
The front lawn is a good start, but the construction zone inside is still a disaster. Kim is about to show Bill how to deal with the dust.
Now, Bill, listen to me. This white dust, it is torture. Damp gets it off.
Okay.
You can't walk up to any heavy dust like that and use a dry cloth, because as you put it down there, it goes and it's all over your face.
Yeah.
I've just got a string mop, my love.
Okay.
And I've dipped it in a bucket of warm, plain water. There's no need to.
Okay.
And this shouldn't be dripping anywhere.
Okay.
By dampening, it stops the dust falling on you. Can you see that?
I had no idea it was on that thick.
I can also touch the light gently, because the cloth is not soaking at all. I wouldn't dream of doing such a thing. Now, houseplants, this is a real one.
Yeah.
I understand that it's thick once again with the white dust. Now, I happen to be carrying in my possession a banana. But don't waste the skin. The skin is potassium. Watch. The plants love it.
Holy moly.
They love it, darling. They love it. They love the oil.
Wow.
They love the potassium. Plants have never been so happy, my lovers, when you put this on them. Look at the shine. Look.
That's fascinating.
I had
no idea.
Honestly, lovey. And you've not wasted the thing. You'd eat the banana after. Look.
Dad is getting into it. While he starts to deal with the dust, Kim moves into the newly renovated kitchen to help Mum keep the shine on the stainless steel.
Lovely satin finish. The good thing about them is they are stainless steel and they don't stain, they mark. Anything that goes on them comes off.
Okay.
Okay. I've just got a bowl of warm water, my love, and I've got dishwashing liquid. Also, I'm going to have it helped by a lemon. It cuts it wonderfully. Also, a notice up there, you've got a label. So yeah. I'm going to take the lemon and I'm going to start it off with that. And the acid in the lemon will clear that label off. I'm going to work on this label.
Wow.
I've got a microfiber duster and I just love them. And if you look at them closely, well, I mean, you know, who's going to... I study them. Oh, no, I'm a bit crack, as you say. I call them inches. It's now sent... Oh, I saw that, you know. I still call them inches.
Yep.
There's more threads to that little inch than in any cloth you'll buy. And it grabs, it just grabs, my love. The fibre's polished beautifully.
Looks fantastic.
Mum has punched the clock and gets busy on the other appliances, and Dad is still working too. But it looks like some of this family crew are still on break.
This is the way we wash our walls, wash our walls, wash our walls. You don't like my singing?
No.
I don't like your laziness.
Max, off the computer, buddy. Come on and help me, okay?
Hello. Hold on a sec. How come we're down here by ourselves?
There's a shock.
The kids seem to be on a permanent break, and Mum and Dad are not pleased. Mike wants to unite the workers through a role reversal exercise.
I want you to destroy Madison's bedroom.
Oh, yay!
All right, how do you feel about that?
Go ahead.
Go ahead? All right, go ahead. You go ahead. I'm gonna go check on the boys.
No, too goofy.
Now, Max, listen. Your father is constantly picking up after you. So you know what, Max? I want your dad to destroy your room.
What?
Let's dump everything. Let's wreck it all.
Let's get rid of this hat.
Perfect.
Look
yes.
At this garbage, money.
There you go, Max.
Look, Max, how does it feel now?
It's beautiful. Thank you so much.
Max, it isn't, and you know it.
No. I don't want that. No. Maybe I'll wear pants today. No. Nah.
Boom. 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 Here we go. What do you think, Max? Having fun with this, so are we having fun?
No, don't want that. Stop!
Oh, stop!
Like, what's that doing here? You haven't washed that in years.
Put it back.
What's wrong? You want your mom to stop?
Yes.
Why?
Because I don't make this much mess.
Looks like Madison might be starting to get it. But Max, not quite yet.
Max, what's going on? How do you feel,
it's
buddy?
Awesome!
It's awesome that all your personal belongings are all over the place?
Yeah, I can, like, sleep on it and stuff.
We're not getting through to you at all, Max, are we?
It's not working.
The McKnight family has started to dust themselves off during their ongoing renovations.
By dampening anything, it stops the dust falling on you.
And they're learning to clean up some of their clutter.
We got some cleaning up to do. Let's go.
Since getting a taste of her own medicine,
stop!
Madison has come around. But Max still isn't getting it.
A lump on a log.
And Mike has had enough.
We're not getting through to you at all, Max, are we?
Nope.
Enough's enough. Family meeting. Yeah, Family meeting. Everybody in the hallway, please. Madison, did you like your mom messing all your stuff up?
I did. It was fun to make
it. Yeah, too bad.
Seeing that your parents destroyed your rooms, guess who has to pick up after them?
Them.
No.
Well, actually, this is a role reversal, Madison. This is the whole point that we did that exercise for.
Life's about respect. Your parents respect you. You should be respecting your parents.
While the kids contemplate the task ahead, Mike takes Dad to the basement to help free the furnace from what seems like the endless stream of dust.
Imagine me giving man maintenance tips other than hair and makeup.
You're no kidding.
Here we go. Now, we all know to clean this lint filter after every load you do.
Right, absolutely.
That's common sense.
Yep.
Now, to take it to the next level, see this hose here? You need to clean that at least once a year. You have to get right in there with a hanger or something and just clean it all out.
That's a good point. I don't do that. I have not done that.
So not many people
good.
Do.
Okay.
But that could cause, it's a fire hazard.
Excellent information, okay.
Next stop, the furnace.
Changing your furnace filters once every 3 months. Very important and very easy. All you have to do, take one of those black felt tip pens, just mark down the date on the side so you know exactly when to change this furnace, because sometimes we forget.
Yeah, I can relate. I frequently forget.
Yeah, so do I.
Yeah. So you're suggesting buying extra filters and then just storing them off on the side, putting a date on for changing.
Took the words out of my mouth.
Perfect.
Okay. Perfect.
Well, that's great.
And though her efforts may not be perfect, Madison is starting to pitch in. So Kim gives her a little lesson on cleaning up ketchup.
Now, how many times have you spilled ketchup on a rug?
Maybe once or twice.
Oh, but your mother loved you, didn't she, dear?
Yeah.
Let me show you how to remove it. Never panic. I'm going to put ketchup on this rug, My mother's going to kill me. You know shaving foams the men wear when they shave?
Yeah.
I don't put much on because it ought to have spread around this. Now, I'm not... Now, look, I'm just going to work it in with my nail, darling. Oh, it's getting lighter, isn't it? Oh, give it a good old do. I'll give it one more time. Now, on it goes again. I'm going to take a damp cloth and I'm just going to do that. It's going to come out. There you are. I think we might have got it there. I'm taking a dry cloth and I'm going to thump it into it. You see, look at that. Good?
Yeah.
Well, don't sound so impressed.
Yeah, that's how a teenager looks impressed. But at least Madison is getting it and pitching in. That's more than can be said for her brother.
Hey, Max, I like to see that you're helping so much. It's great, buddy.
You have such a hard life, don't you?
Even harder when someone hides your computer.
Mom, where's my laptop?
Looking for the laptop, eh?
Yeah.
Have you done any housework in this house, Max?
No.
And why do you think your whole family are working and you shouldn't?
Because I'm just special like that.
Ha ha. Get your family together. Want to see you in the front garden.
Let's go, McKnight family, outside.
You lazy little beggar.
Come on, we have a surprise for you outside.
I think Kim and Mike are all obsessed with the cleaning and the dusting and the white dust and the green tape and, yeah, it's called renovation.
Kim and Mike aren't impressed with Max, and they're about to use some of his prized possessions to help cement the idea of cleaning into his head.
Max, we have a skateboard that was once yours and a keyboard that was once yours, and now they're covered in cement.
Oh.
Max, we need you to help your family out with this house.
Good luck with that.
Don't you be so impudent. Give him a hard lesson.
Your laptop.
Give. Steve? What?
Yes, your laptop. Bring it. Start it up, Steve. Start it up.
No, all my stuff is on this. You can't get rid of it.
Yes, we can. If you don't do housework, what are you going to do?
I'll sue you guys.
Put it in, Steve.
I'm fine. I won't clean. I'll clean.
Well, what was that, dear?
I'll clean.
Good answer.
You cut it very fine there, didn't you?
Now Max is finally clear on his instructions, as is the rest of the family.
Everywhere.
Kim and Mike have taught the McKnights that even during renovations, a little dusting can go a long way.
Look at this.
That clutter just adds to the reno chaos, and that the entire family has to start working together. But is it enough for the family to make it through the final challenge?
Now, family, your final challenge is this. It's time for you guys now to work together as a family, work together as a team, and get this house organized and ready for a party.
Woohoo!
And we'll make sure that we show off your house. Got it? Back in the house, McKnights.
Get in!
I'm really hoping that Max will take Mike and Kim's advice to heart and will start listening to us without us having to ask 5, 6, 10, 50 times for him to do something.
While it looks like the entire family is helping out, looks can be deceiving. Max is still just stuffing all his junk under his bed so he can get back to his beloved computer.
We've got work to do. Darn it, Max. Get your butt upstairs right now. Come on.
I don't think I'm going to be helping to clean up this house. It's fine. No need to clean.
The McKnights have been working all week to dust themselves off after their nonstop renos.
Damp gets it off.
They've learned how to clear out the clutter.
Nobody's getting into this house unless you clean up this dump.
And how to keep all their renovations looking new.
And the acid and the lemon will clear that label off.
With just hours left before Kim and Mike return for the party, Mom, Dad, and Madison are all pitching in to help make their show home shine. But Max still needs some convincing.
I'm getting so annoyed with you. You're so bloody lazy.
Let's get this thing done.
Okay.
I've had it. I've had it. I'm motivated to get the darn thing done.
Okay, I think you heard
it. Yes, I know.
All right, let's go.
Maddie, come on in, sweetie. Help me start packing up some stuff.
I know you can do it. I know you can do it. Come on, Max. Let's go clean. Come on. Let's go. Let's go clean.
Looks like Max is finally helping out. And thankfully, he's not using his cleaning method of choice.
Can we burn it?
No, we can't burn it.
Oh, gosh. You're so dusty.
Max, take your hockey stuff out of here, okay? Get it out of here. Near the front door, put it in your room.
Throw it out.
No, you're not throwing your hockey stuff out yet, bud.
I'm seeing some, the defiance seems to be a little bit less and the moaning and seems to be lessening, so it's coming. Yeah, definitely it's coming along a bit.
The McKnights are finally working together as a united crew to get their dream home back from the dusty grasp of home renovations.
Wave goodbye to our junk. See you later, alligator. Bye.
The donations to charity are on their way, but will the family be ready in time? Because Kim and Mike and family and friends are on their way to see if the McKnights have finally started to treat their newly renovated home with the respect it deserves. Up first, a look down the dusty trail from which this family came. It's the Theater of Shame.
We want to show you what we walked into when we came into this McKnight house.
Oh my God.
And whose room is this?
Mine.
Oh. Madison's room went from a garbage pile where things didn't get thrown out, they just got thrown down, into a clean and organized teenage living space. Yeah.
Upside down basement.
Oh my God.
What do you think of this?
I think it looks really bad and messy.
The basement went from a junk room used only for storage to a clutter-free and very welcoming family room.
Everything is shining.
Ah, yes. Here's Max's room.
Oh my God. Oh,
that was fun to sleep in.
Max, for the first time ever, didn't just hide his mess, he actually cleaned up his bedroom.
Max, this is unbelievable.
Didn't think you'd do it, you know. So now is party time.
Oh my God. This is amazing.
I think we can keep it up. It might start twirling a bit down from that, but I think we can like bounce back and everything.
See how much Maddie cleaned up her room.
Looks fantastic. Wow.
Since I cleaned it, looks really good now.
The transition of your house, the renovations, and the dust all gone, it looks absolutely beautiful.
Just a smash
it. It really, really does. Well done, family.
All right, goodbye, everybody.
Thank you.
I don't think things will go back the way they were because I think Bill and I will make a conscious effort to really keep on top of the kids.
I love the way we've evolved this house into what it looks like today. I just cannot allow it to revert back to the old ways. No way.